Seems there's quite a bit of interest in the topping PA5 amplifier, which is the one on top. Not so much about the E50 DAC, which is the one below, but I think you do need a good source of digital to analog conversion to get a nice clean analog signal to feed into your amplifier, especially if your amplifier is of the low distortion, low noise kind, and that's what you're looking for or want, which in this case, it's exactly what I would like. I'll plug them in. I just have them both plugged into this. We do that, and we notice that the DAC has a little light that comes on. It actually looks pretty orange to me. Don't know if it's going to show up the same color. The power amp on the top, so that's got a hard switch. Another white light. And then we can power on the DAC like that. As you can see, it's set up to use USB, but that's easy to change. Even if you don't have the remote, you can tap here a few times. Now it's optical, tap again, coax, put it back on USB, just use the remote. So this power amplifier does have a hard knob to control the volume. The feeling is very smooth, doesn't really have any tactile feedback, as far as I can tell. Maybe my fingers are not as sensitive as other people's. Anyway, so I don't really worry about that. I tend to leave the amp at a suitably high level and then have the DAC acting as a preamp and use the remote for the DAC to then control it. So I can sit down and drop the volume as the track changes. Yeah, so first impressions, plugging this one in compared to this amplifier into the same speakers as before. I've got some, let me show you quickly. They're old speakers, sure, but what's kind of interesting is notice the sensitivity. So 93 decibels, you know, at 1 meter, blah blah blah. But the point being is on the old amplifier that this topping PA5 has replaced, there was used to be a hum, like a power hum, and then also a hiss, and it was slightly different from one channel to another, the other speaker. But swapping the speakers, it would just stay on whatever channel that you're plugged into, so it wasn't the speakers. These speakers now are absolutely dead quiet. I can put my ear right up to the speaker, and there's zero noise, you know, if it's not playing. So that's a good sign that there's no hiss. There's also no pops, no crackles when turning it off or on. It is plugged in right now to the two speakers, which are just sitting next to me. So if I turn this off, it's the only noise you hear is the click of the switch. Same with on. So I tend to feed it with the USB. I've set mine up to the output to be a little higher, so you'll notice the frequency pops up here. Set it to 96 kilohertz, and then it goes back to just showing the output. So yeah, the amplifiers seems to work well, seems to be very transparent, as in it does not seem to color the sound, doesn't make it sound warm or clear or whatever, tinny, etc. It just seems to get out the way, except for making the sound louder, which is good, if that's what you want. Yeah, the amplifier's been running for a good few hours today. Slightly warm to the touch, nothing excessive. This is quite an accurate little thermometer. This is the room temperature, it's about 26 for Fahrenheit people. That's about 80 degrees. Yes, it's very hot here today, which is why I'm hiding inside, but the upside is you're getting a video out of it. So if we click here, 27, this is 28. So it's barely warmer. And it's warm to the touch. It's cooled down a bit now because I've been, while making the video, I had to unplug everything and move it over here. Basically, I'm happy with the amplifier. there's probably a bit of bias in that because I purchased it, so I've already spent my money on it, made my decision. I don't tend to drive it too hard, no more than 40 watts, because I don't want distortion. So I'm trying to play in that zone where the amplifier is not, starting to cause any of that. So this amplifier and DAC combination has been heavily used over the last 2 weeks. Kind of almost like a burn-in situation, except I'm just playing music and listening to music. So that's very useful just to make sure there's no like out-of-the-box type failures. So I'm very happy with the reliability so far, but I mean 2 weeks is only 2 weeks. But plugged it in, turned it on, it worked. There's been no issues. It hasn't done anything weird. I haven't had to turn it off and turn it back on again. I've not had to, I don't know, fiddle with the remote to get it to work. It just, put two batteries in it and it works. You push a button, it changes. I mean, that's more on the DAC side, but same with the power amp. There's no like having to switch between input one and input two on this lever. Use whatever's plugged in. Maybe I should show you. I have used some decent cables. These are actually the cables from Topping. I thought, well, I'm buying both of these. I might as well get the same brand just for neatness and aesthetics more than anything else. These are quite nice cables from what I can see. Robust, thick, woven. Anyway, so they're balanced, which I think if you're trying to use this power amp, you need balanced inputs. And this DAC has balanced outputs, which is why I paired them together. And yes, they also match up the dimensions. I've just turned it slightly and it looks a bit off now. But oh yeah, total height less than 8 centimeters because you've got about half a centimeter this side. So yeah, tiny basically. But in fact, these cables sticking out the back are what brings the entire length needed or depth in your cabinet to about 30 centimeters or 12 inches, including the power or the amplifier's power or volume knob on the front, because those all stick out a little bit. Yeah, so banana plugs seem great, don't want to come out, don't fall out, haven't come loose. Not that I'm unplugging and replugging. I set it up and I use it, and that's where it sits. I've literally unplugged it for the first time today just to make this video, to bring it over to this table and set it up again. In fact, I can tell you another thing. Things are so quiet with this combination that I can hear the fan in the laptop because obviously it's a bit hot with this weather. And that's the noise I hear. In fact, at one point I was suspecting, do I have a problem? Turned off the laptop. I'm like, or move the laptop. I'm like, nope, the sound follows the laptop. So that's how quiet this combination is. Seems to have enough power to drive these speakers, but these speakers are only rated at 20, I think it's 20 watts each or 25 watts, so the amplifier is more than powerful enough. I'm trying not to destroy the speakers with it. The other thing is the speaker combination, the two speakers plugged in here are like one-way speakers. There's like one full range driver in each of them, and I don't think that's good enough. So this has now kicked off another little project. Actually going to go and build some good speakers for this combination, yeah. So maybe that's a good testament to how good it sounds as far as I'm concerned. That lack of hum, hiss, noise, pops, crackles, and yeah, I'm pretty sure it's not the source of any distortion because I can compare on the old amplifier with the same speakers. Yeah, so I'm looking forward to getting some new speakers built, and I will plug them in and then see if it sounds any better. Unfortunately, I'm not going to bother playing you any sounds because that's the microphone in this recording device does not do justice at all to the music or the sound. So it's just really pointless. And then even if it did, your speakers and YouTube's compression algorithms or whatever video upload site this is ends up on will render that moot. One thing to be aware of this amplifier though, it's low gain. If you go look up the specs, it doesn't claim to have that much gain, but because it takes balanced inputs, you can get a fair amount of signal into it. So you should be thinking about the voltage that's coming in here. So I wouldn't really want to take an unbalanced output and then convert it to a balanced output with some sort of adapter cable and then feed it into here. I don't think you'd be getting the best out of the amp, but you know, I haven't tried it, so I'm just saying I don't think you would. I'm speculating, in other words. That's something to look up and do your research on if you don't have something that can feed the amp with balanced inputs. So just turn the DAC down as far as I can and amplify it all the way up. And I can start hearing faint little sounds at about minus 70 dB. So I can't really push this too much up, copyright, etc. But there we go, 60. Can actually hear the words already. Interesting, huh? Oh, and the mute button as well also works. But if you turn the volume up and down, then you lose the mute. Well, unmute it, I should say. Well, I hope that's useful. I can't think of anything else. That's, you know, it's very unremarkable. In other words, it just gets out the way, does its thing, and yeah, seems reliable. Nice, clear sound. It's not warm, it's not cold, as far as I can see, or here, I should say. Yeah, anyway, can't fault it, basically. And now I get to edit the video. So let me put this all back so I can listen to some music while I'm doing that. So that kind of shows you how often and how much this thing is getting used, or both this pair, I should say. Basically, I had to stop listening to music to make this video on it. So I'm enjoying it. So yeah, that's the long and short of it. If there's any other questions, I suppose let me know in the comments and then I can make a follow-up video. Hope that helps. Cheers.